Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum students. It's me, your chemistry teacher, Ms. Tahmina Nazir from APS and C, Khanewar. It's week 2 and day 1 and we are studying 5th chapter of chemistry, physical states of matter. Today students, we will be able to understand gaseous states and the laws related to the gases. Means Charles law with the help of example. Your concept must be clear, students. So listen carefully. What is gaseous state? Gases are the state of matter. There are three states of matter present in the world. First, liquid, solid, and gases. Here we will discuss about the gases. Gases are the highly compressible. Gases molecules are compressible because gas molecules are further apart from each other. They have more intermolecular space between them. So when we apply pressure, like you see in this picture, when we apply pressure, their molecules come close to each other and their volume become decreases. So gas, it is the nature of gas that they have large intermolecular spaces between them. Okay. Laws related to the gases. There are 3 or 4 variables which interact with each other. Their relationship, on the basis of their relationship, they form 2 laws, which are Boyle's law and Charles law. The relationships of their variables are called gas law. Here we will discuss about Charles law. Okay students, Charles law state for constant mass and pressure. Constant in Charles law, pressure and mass of the gas kept constant, and volume and the temperature increase or decrease with respect to each other. Here, in Charles law, volume directly proportional to the temperature. You can see in this picture, when we apply or give a low amount of gas, low temperature, their volume become decreases. And in this picture, when we increase temperature, their volume also be increases. That means volume and temperature are directly proportional to each other. Okay. The equations, mathematical equation is volume over temperature is equal constant. Here V1 or T1 is initial volume and temperature. When we increase the temperature, their volume also increases, and it's V2 over T2 is final volume and temperature, and here V1 or T1 is the initial volume and temperature. These two temperatures and these two volumes become constant. They will be equal to each other. Then Charles law will be obeyed. Okay, here example, like a bubble of air trapped in a pool of water has a volume of 1.20 centimeter cube at the 24 centimeter cube, at 24 Celsius. Calculate the temperature in Celsius of air bubble when the volume became 1.26 centimeter cube. Here we apply this formula of Charles law, V1 over T1 is equal V2 over T2. Here V1 is initial volume. What is initial volume? Here 1.2 is initial volume, and initial temperature is 24. Okay students, Celsius temperature, unit of temperature is Kelvin. So we must convert the Celsius into Kelvin by adding two 273 variables, 273 Kelvin. Okay, this is initial temperature and final temperature volume, final 1.26, and we will find, we have to find final temperature. This is the formula and example of Charles' law. We can the help of this formula, we can from the help of this formula we can solve many problems. Here is summary: volume and temperature always be constant in Charles' law, and the pressure amount of gas will be constant. The relationship between volume and temperature directly proportional to the each other. This is a summary of the Charles' law. Okay, there are three questions. What is the relationship between temperature and volume? What is absolute zero define as absolute? What is Charles' law formula? These three questions you should learn. Okay, students, do practice, and thank you. Today's lecture is over.